जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवास आदि गौर भक्तवृंदा। हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्णा। टुडे इज़ द मोस्ट ऑस्पिशियस डे ऑफ रथ यात्रा एट श्री जगन्नाथपुरी धाम। सो ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ ऑल ऑफ अस आई प्रे टू श्री श्री जगन्नाथ बलदेव सुभद्रा दैट दे इटर्नली एंगेज अस in the services of the lotus feet. So with that we'll start today's session. And in the last session actually we're discussing about many things, but in particular about how to attain the abode of Krishna. So Krishna advises that somebody who would like to go back to the spiritual kingdom, you know, to the Goloka Vrindavan. So as per our diagram, you know, the Goloka Vrindavan is right over here. And since we were remembering Jagannath Ji, so the Jagannath Dham or Jagannath Puri Dham is in the Goloka Vrindavan realm. So here is the Dwarka and here is the Jagannath Puri and this is Mathura. So Lord Jagannath exists eternally in the Goloka Vrindavan realm and he manifests himself in the earth, you know, at Jagannath Puri, Odisha, and he displays his pastime with the devotees, and you can hear many pastimes of Lord Jagannath, very exciting pastimes actually, and he performs these pastimes with the devotee so that, you know, we hear those pastimes and we get attracted to go back to Lord Jagannath and serve him. And once in a year, normally Lord Jagannath comes out of the temple to give darshan to those who are, you know, very unfortunate and who have not participated in entering the Jagannath Puri temple, you know, to take his darshan. So he himself is so merciful that he himself comes out. And Jagannath means he is the Lord of Jagat. Jagat is the universe. So he is a Lord of the universe. So that's a very special form of Krishna. And you can read more about Jagannath Puri and the pastimes of Lord Jagannath, Baladev and Subhadra with their devotees. So continuing our discussion, that the way to remember or way to go back to the Krishna Loka or Goloka Vrindavan or to the Vaikuntha planets, you know, is when we leave the body, if we can remember Krishna at the time of leaving the body, then we attain the nature of transcendental nature of Krishna. So this same discussion is being continued, that if we do not remember, then what happens is we go into the cycle of birth and death, and the next body is decided by the Yamaraj based on the current activities. So here you can see that the soul is brought in front of Yamaraj, and then the Yamaraj decides what needs to be done with that particular soul, and then based on the previous karma, the body of that new body is given to that soul. So then Prabhupada discusses destinations of different transcendentalists. So somebody who is attracted to the Brahman feature of the Lord, they go to the Brahmajyoti. So Brahmajyoti is nothing but is the effulgence of the Lord. And if you see, this is the effulgence coming out of the body of the Lord. So that is Brahmajyoti. So somebody can like just hang out in the Brahmajyoti. But that is not recommended because there is no service to the Lord, to the personal form of the Lord. So when we do not perform any service, we do not relish, you know, the ananda feature. The ananda can be only relished by performing service to the Lord. So that's why that is not recommended. And next is the Paramatma feature of the Lord. So one can experience the Lord as a Paramatma in the heart. And then the third is a Bhagawan. So somebody who is attracted to the Bhagawan feature, they are then they can go to the Vaikuntha planets at the end of the life. If they can remember the form of Krishna, then they can go to the Vaikuntha planets, which is the Vaikuntha planets over here, or दे कैन ईदर गो टू गोलोका. सो डिपेंडिंग ऑन देयर रसा और देयर इंक्लिनेशन दे कैन ईदर गो हियर और दे कैन गो टू दी हायर प्लैनेट्स ओवर हियर इन दी गोलोका रेल्म और दे कैन ऑल्सो गो टू अयोध्या और जगन्नाथपुरी और मथुरा यू नो. सो वी सॉ ऑल दिस डिफरेंट प्लेसेस द्वारका जगन्नाथपुरी मथुरा अयोध्या. सो दीज आर द डिफरेंट रेल्म्स स्पिरिचुअल रेल्म्स इन विच द लिविंग एंटिटी गो कैन गो आफ्टर दे लीव द बॉडी. बट वॉट इज द कंडीशन एट द टाइम ऑफ द लीविंग द बॉडी द डिवोट द सोल हैज टू एक्चुअली थिंक अबाउट कृष्णा. But if they think about something else, like the dogs or cats or whatever, you know, if they think or whatever they are attached to, then they can go or attain that particular form. So that's why, you know, it is said that when the soul is leaving the body, the entire life is shown as in a picture form. The whole life, is whatever they are done in the whole life, it is shown to them. It's like a movie. And then whatever we are attached, we get hooked to that. And then we get the next body based on that. So that's why the next paragraph, which we'll start today discussing, is about the general principle. The Bhagavad Gita 8.6 also explains the general principle that makes possible to enter into the spiritual kingdom simply by thinking of the Supreme at the time of death. Yam yam vapi smaran bhavam tajatyante kalevaram तम तमे वैति कौन्तेय सदा तद भाव भावितः. वॉट एवर स्टेट ऑफ बीइंग वन रिमेंबर्स व्हेन ही क्विट्स हिज प्रेजेंट बॉडी इन हिज नेक्स्ट लाइफ ही विल अटेन टू दैट स्टेट विदाउट फेल. नाउ फर्स्ट वी मस्ट अंडरस्टैंड दैट मटेरियल नेचर इज अ डिस्प्ले ऑफ वन ऑफ द एनर्जीज ऑफ द सुप्रीम लॉर्ड. सो वॉट एवर स्टेट वी और वॉट एवर वी कैन थिंक एट द टाइम ऑफ डेथ वॉट एवर वी आर थिंकिंग एट द टाइम ऑफ डेथ depending on that we will get our next body. So this was a presentation which I made before all these pictures came, so just to give some understanding. So it's not as good as those pictures, but these pictures gives us more clear ideas. But at that time, you know, it was not available, so just to give an idea that this is a demarcation between the material world and the spiritual world. So Brahma Jyoti is part of the spiritual world, and Brahmavadis, they go there. The Jiva is actually superior energy, and the material world is itself is an inferior energy. It's called as apara, and superior means para. So Jiva or living entities or soul, they are superior energy, and the spiritual world also is a superior energy. So the devotees and the Paramatmavadis, they go to the transcendental realm, the spiritual planets. Now, here you have this earth, and somebody who do not remember Krishna at the time of death, then they continue into the cycle of birth and death within this circle. So this whole area, the bigger circle, is the entire material universe. And then within that entire material universes or material creation rather, there are many universes. So all this, you know, shell kind of thing, you know, is all actually, these are different universes, and we are in one of that universe. So this is one universe. So again, if you compare this picture, so within this picture, if you see that this is the one universe which we are seeing, but there are other universes, and in all the other universes there are demigods and Brahma. So in our universe, the Brahmaji has 4 heads. So some of the universe Brahmaji has 10 heads, 100 heads, 1000 heads, like that. And each universes will have demigods which help Krishna in running the show of that universe. Right. So and again, within the universe, if you also you see, there are these planetary systems. So here we have this floating planetary systems. There also there are planetary systems. Right. So in our scriptures right now, you know, the information is based on our universe only. we know that there are other universes because that reference is given, but the details in those universes are not given. Right. So continuing our discussion, in the Vishnu Puran 6761, the total energies of the Supreme Lord are delineated. So the energies of the Krishnas are discussed, and that is Vishnu Shakti Para Prokta Kshetra Gnanakya Tatha Para Avidya Karma Sam Gnanya Tritya Shaktir Ishyate. This is also available in, found in Chaitanya Charitamrita Madhya Leela 6.154. The Supreme Lord has diverse and innumerable energies which are beyond our conception. However, great learned sages or liberated soul have studied these energies and have analyzed them into three parts. So we studied this earlier in the earlier discussions of introduction. And these Shaktis are like three types, like Antaranga, Bahiranga and Tatastha. All the energies are of Vishnu Shakti. That is to say that they are different potencies of the Lord Vishnu. The first energy is para, means transcendental. Yes, that is, para is the realm in. So if you see this picture, excuse me, so this is the para prakriti, the jiva and the sub spiritual world. So these are all under the para prakriti, or superior energy or transcendental energy. Living entities also belong to the superior energy, as has already been explained. The other energies or marginal energies are in the mode of ignorance, because the matter doesn't have consciousness. So that is why it is considered as inferior or in ignorance. At the time of death, either we can remain in the inferior energy of this material world, or we can transfer to the energy of the spiritual world. So Bhagavad Gita says 8.6, yam yam vapi smaran bhavam tajyatyante kalevaram tam tame vaiti kaunteya sadatad bhava bhavita. So this verse is so important that in introduction itself Prabhupada is mentioning this twice, because this is a key factor, you know, is a key thing, you know, of getting out of the cycle of birth and death. Whatever we think at the time of death, you know, we attain that. So it's very critical to practice in this life so that we prepare for our next destination. So we can either continue in the cycle of birth and death, or if we choose to go to the spiritual world, if we decide to do that, then we have to start acting immediately. So for that, what is required? So for that, you need to understand about the Lord and the details about the Lord and our position. So that is the Sambandha Gyan, right? And then Abhideya. Then the Abhideya is a process. So there is the process that needs to be followed. And the process that needs to be followed is also very clearly given. That is Harer Nama, Harer Nama, Harer Nama, Eva Kevalam. Kalau means Harer Nama, Harer Nama, Harer Nama, Eva Kevalam. It is repeated three times. Means chanting the holy name of the Lord, chanting the holy name of the Lord, chanting the holy name of the Lord is the only way. Yeah, that is the meaning of Harer Nama, Harer Nama, Harer Nama, Eva Kevalam. And then it says Kalau. Kalau means in the age of Kali. Nasteva, Nasteva, Nasteva Gatiranyata. So then it is saying that in the age of Kali, there is no other way, there is no other way, there is no other way. So it is in kind of repeating six times. Chanting the holy name of the Lord, chanting the holy name of the Lord, chanting the holy name of the Lord is the only way in the age of Kali. There is no other way, there is no other way, there is no other way. So that is the process. So chanting is the process. That's why if you carefully see this picture, so there is a Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, you can see like this going up. So that mantra actually is the key that takes us from this world to the it's going up and up and up to the spiritual world. So this is the mantra that can take us from the earthly planet where we are right now to the spiritual world. So this is the only way. There is no other way. There is no other way. There is no other way. That's what our scriptures say. Which scriptures? Many scriptures. But in particular, the Kali Santaran Upanishad. Kali Santaran Upanishad is a scripture which is designed or which is gives us the way to get out from the cycle of birth and death in the age of Kali. So you can see in this picture also, you know, the same you know, thread is there. It's coming down. This is a thread of Hare Krishna. So see, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna. So this is a Maha Mantra actually. So Hare Krishna, the mantra is called as Maha Mantra. Maha Mantra means the topmost mantra. And that mantra actually helps us to cleanse our mind. And when our mind is cleansed of all the dirt, then we are in purified consciousness. So when the beginning of introduction, Prabhupada mentions about this concept of purified consciousness. Right now, our consciousness is not purified. It's contaminated. So if we have to go to the spiritual world, then we have to purify our consciousness. And that is only possible by chanting this mantra, which is Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. It's a 16-lettered word. Which is Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So when we chant this mantra, this process actually is helps us to be situated gradually in purified consciousness. So we are going to discuss about that later. But the essential point is that once somebody decides that I want to go back to Godhead, and this is what I want to do, then they have to follow the process, which is the Abhideya. So there are three things which we discussed: Sambandha, and this is our teachings of Lord Chaitanya. Sambandha, Abhideya, and Prayojana. So Sambandha means understanding about Krishna, understanding about us, understanding about the material nature. So those 5 points, you know, who is God, who am I, what is time, what is material nature, what is karma. So understanding all these things and then following a process. The process is the process of chanting of the holy name. And then what is a goal? So goal is to go the achieve the pure love of for Krishna. So that is the prayojana. So this is the whole purpose of the Vedic literature. This is what is the next topic. The purpose of the Vedic literature. In life, we are accustomed to thinking either of the material or of the spiritual energy. Now, how can we transfer our thoughts from the material energy to the spiritual energy? So, material energy means whatever we see around us. So, that is material energy. So, our thought is always absorbed in that material energy. That's what Prabhupada is meaning, you know. And then, he is saying, in the example, there are so many literatures which fill our thoughts with the material energy. The newspapers, the magazine, novels, etc. Our thinking, which is now absorbed in this literature, must be transferred to the Vedic literatures. So, when we read some magazine, when we read some newspaper, then our mind is like clouded with that information and our thought process immediately go into that. And we keep thinking about that. So, actually, after the introduction, I'm going to talk about how mind works. You know, there will be a session on that. And it's a very important session to understand how the mind works. And based on the teachings of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. So, we're going to understand that. And when we understand, then we will understand this particular message, what Prabhupada is saying. How our mind is clouded with those kind of information. And we have to remove those information or replace those information with the Vedic literature, information from the Vedic literature. If we decide that at the end of the life, I want to quit this body and go back to Godhead. So that decision we have to make it first. So, you know, as Stephen, Dr. Stephen Covey in the seven habits of highly effective people, you know, it's a very, those seven habits are really nice. If you get chance, you can read about those. So he starts that the first habit is like begin with the end in mind. So begin with the end in mind. So what is end? So end is if you want to go back to God, right? So now you have to start doing something towards that journey. So what are we going to do? So the first step is given by Prabhupada over here, that remove all the junk, which is junk information, which is sitting on our mind, and then replace it with the Vedic literature. So our thinking, which is now absorbed with the in these literatures, which literatures? Newspapers, magazine, novels, etc. Now, are they going to help us to get out of the cycle of birth and death? Yeah, so they are not, for sure. So they are actually hindrances. So then we need to remove it out. And whatever information which we are getting from this, these are all temporary. It's not that they are false, but they are temporary and it's not going to help us, or neither we are going to be able to change any situation. So wherever we are, wherever it's possible, you know, we help the society, we help out people in way we, it is possible. So that is not, you know, it's not saying that, you know, the Vedic literature doesn't say that you don't help the society, you don't become good citizens. No, that's not true. Actually, in fact, we become better citizens by understanding the spiritual concept. You know, then we don't discriminate people and, you know, start thinking, oh, this is, this person is like this or that. You know, there are so many things going on currently in this world. That is because people don't have correct spiritual knowledge. But once they have spiritual knowledge, then they see all the living entity as spirit soul. And they see them as part and parcel of Krishna. Right? And so that vision is so high, actually. So you respect, you help wherever is necessary to all the living entities. So we are not like, you know, giving up our duties just by transferring our absorption from these mundane literatures to the Vedic literatures. Now, these literatures have very high philosophy, actually, Vedic literatures, and it changes our consciousness in such a way that, you know, we are placed in a very high consciousness, state of very high consciousness, and we see the things in proper perspective. And then actually we can help the living entity in a proper way. So the first step is our thinking, which is now absorbed in these literatures, must be transferred to the Vedic literatures. The great sages therefore have written so many Vedic literatures, such as Puranas. The Puranas are not imaginative, they are not mythology. They are historical records. Nowadays, you know, whatever doesn't fit our brain, you know, we tend to make it as a mythology. So this is what is happening, because it doesn't fit our logic. But there are many things that doesn't fit our logic. Even in science, there are many things which doesn't fit our logic, but it's there. So anyway, we believe, we not believe, we have a firm faith that these are all historical records. Puranas means something which is old, you know. In Hindi also Purana is old. So similarly, Puranas is something is which is there from our history. It has happened. Like, you know, the Battle of Kurukshetra has happened. And how can we say that? Because that land is still there. If you go to India, you see Hastinapur, which is New Delhi. You see Kurukshetra, which is also there. Whatever we are reading here, all those places are there. And then there are temples there. You know, the tree under which Krishna gave the information, that is also there. So all this historical record, like Dwaraka is there, where Krishna's palace was there. So they found remains in Dwaraka, underwater, you know, that there are palaces and all. So the point is, those places are already, which is mentioned in the Puranas, which is mentioned in Itihasas, they are all there actually in India. So in the Chaitanya Charitamrita Madhya Lila 21-22, there is the following verse. So this verse is very nice verse, which actually we started with this verse. If you recall, we started the introduction in the overview of Vedas. We started with this verse where it says, Maya Mugda Jivir Nahi Swata Krishna Gyan Jivir Kripai Kailo Krishna Veda Puran. So the forgetful living entities or conditioned souls have forgotten their relationship with the Supreme Lord. And they are engrossed in thinking of the material activities. Just to transfer their thinking power to the spiritual sky, Krishna Dvaipayana Vyasa, or Vyasadeva name is Krishna Dvaipayana Vyasa, has given a number of Vedic literatures. First, he divided the Vedas into four, then he explained them in the Puranas. For less capable people, he wrote Mahabharata. In the Mahabharata, there is given the Bhagavad Gita. Then, all Vedic literature is summarized in Vedanta Sutra. And for further guidance, he gave natural commentary on the commentation on the Vedanta Sutra called as Srimad Bhagavatam. Right? So, Vyasadeva have spent so much time giving us these scriptures. And some of the scriptures are, like Vedanta Sutra is pretty deep actually. It's not very easily understandable. So then he gave a commentation. Natural commentation means whatever is there in Vedanta Sutra, then he presented the pastimes which happened based on those instructions which are there in the Vedanta Sutra. So that is a natural commentation on, and that book is called Srimad Bhagavatam. We must always engage our mind in reading these Vedic literatures. Just as materialists engage their mind in reading newspaper, magazine, and so many materialistic literatures, we must transfer our reading to these literatures which are given to us by Vyasadeva. So, this is what Prabhupada is saying, that instead of, putting our energy and thoughts into those literatures which will actually not help us, it is going to bind us. So instead of putting our thoughts in those, we transfer our reading ability to and gets absorbed in reading this Vedic literature. So that is going to help us for what? Getting absorbed into the pastimes of Krishna. And when we read more about Krishna, then our doubts about Krishna will go away gradually. And our attachment for Krishna will increase. And that was the purpose of these Vedic literatures. So that will help the living entity to gradually detach from this cycle of birth and death and get more absorbed in Krishna. And when one get more and more absorbed in Krishna, so at the time of death, what will happen? Yam yam vapi smaran bhavan tajetvante kalevaram tam tame vaiti konteya sadata dabhava bhavita. So, then at that point of time, the living entity will be able to remember Krishna because now his thoughts are absorbed in Krishna. And if the living entity is able to remember Krishna at the time of death, then the living entity can achieve the purpose of life. Like Prabhupada says, life is a preparation, death is an examination. So, what is the preparation? The preparation is read the Vedic literature very carefully. So, we must read Srimad Bhagavad Gita and Srimad Bhagavatam, starting with Srimad Bhagavad Gita. Understand it very carefully. That's what we are trying to attempt over here. Go over the subject matter very in detail and read every line of this book and try to understand the message of those, whatever is given here. So, this is Prabhupada is discussing in this particular paragraph, and we will continue discussing what is Krishna's advice to Arjuna based on what we have studied in the next session. Srila Prabhupada ki jai, Srimad Bhagavad Gita ki jai, Gaur Premanande Haribol.